Hi there! This is the next Devlog for the Droid colony building game I'm making with my own engine. In the last episode, we've seen the Droid successfully mining blocks, so it makes sense that the next step is to teach them how to place blocks. Placing blocks should require some resources, so let's work on that first. Now when the player mines a block, a little resource particle flies to them and they get a corresponding resource. The same happens when droids mine blocks, although it's a bit hard to see since the particles move quite fast and there's no way to see the droid's inventory yet. I also noticed some weird performance drops when the droids get closer to these mountains. It turned out that they were trying to reach the top of these mountains but couldn't find a path there, and Pathfinding was basically trying to explore the whole map to find a path. I thought about this problem for a while and decided to implement two important Pathfinding optimizations. The first one is to make Pathfinding bidirectional. While trying to find the path from the source to the target block, I simultaneously try to find the path from the target towards the source block. This improves things a lot in cases when the target block cannot be reached, like in a closed room or on top of a mountain. The second optimization is to run Pathfinding asynchronously. This doesn't mean it will be in a different thread though, but simply that it will be run in small explicit discrete steps, so that I can limit the number of Pathfinding steps that happen during a single simulation frame. At this point, I felt some inspiration to improve the droid model. I rounded the edges a bit and added these antennas that look a bit like ears and make the droids appear more friendly. I also added support for more metallic looking materials by adding specular highlights in the rendering engine. This required me to add a material buffer to my deferred shading pipeline. This is how this buffer looks in the game. It encodes the roughness and reflectivity of each pixel. Enough for distractions. It was time to actually implement placing blocks. I figured that it would be interesting if you needed a special tool for that, so I made this simple Welder model. As you can see, it allows the player to place some blocks, provided they have enough resources in their inventory. After playing with this new tool a bit, I decided to remove the tool warm-up mechanic. At first, I thought it might be an interesting addition that would require the player to balance energy use or something like that, but now I've realized that it's just annoying. After that, I finally taught the droids how to execute block placing tasks. This wasn't hard since they already knew how to mine blocks, so most of the necessary code was already there. I also implemented cancelling tasks, which sounds like a useful thing. I figured that it would be nice to have some visual indication of the process of building something, so I added these little sparkle particles. Honestly, they look a bit pathetic, but this will do for now. For quite a long time, I had the idea that if a droid has two identical tools equipped in its hands, then it can use them simultaneously, speeding up whatever these tools do. So I implemented that as well. As you can see, now I can mine blocks way faster than I did before. I thought that it was about the time to add some crafting to the game. Crafting naturally requires some crafting machines, so I need a system to build and operate these machines. I started with an antenna as a simple test object. As you can see, it properly collides with the terrain. I can even mine blocks under the antenna and it will fall down. However, if I place fallen blocks like sand on top of it, it kind of gets buried inside. To be honest, I'm still not quite sure if that's a bug or a feature. I can also jump on top of the antenna and collisions will properly work, although I can't jump while standing on it, and I kind of slide around, so I'd say the physics needs some tweaking. Then I added a bloomery, which will be used to smelt ores or something like that. They require cobblestone and some patience to be constructed. They use some temporary texture that I'm honestly not really proud of. I also made it so that it cannot be buried in sand. I'm still not sure whether this is how it should work though. Okay, the crafting machines are here, but there's nothing to craft yet. So I added a bunch of new block types. Coal, iron ore, and copper ore. Now if I go to a bloomery, it has this temporary interface that allows me to insert some fuel and ores, and it smelts them into iron and copper. There's no use for these new resources yet, so this will have to wait until the next devlog. I also realized that bloomeries look a bit pathetic, so I made them a little larger. I think they're about the right size now. That's it for today. Of course, like and subscribe if you're interested in this project. There are also a few other projects I've been working on, so I'll probably talk about them at some point as well. Thanks for watching and see you!